Thank you very much. I hope you will hear me. I am Vera Klapcic. I am a researcher in the field of human rights, and I am also working very closely with the Roma community in Slovenia on the issues of research and collecting data on Roma genocide. If we are talking about, please allow me first to give a short overview about the situation of Roma in Slovenia, also some historical facts. Because as in other European countries, persecution of Roma started centuries ago. And in my work, I use the word Roma, as it is in our constitution, as it was also decided on the World Roma Congress in 1971, we use the word Roma. But if I reflect or quote historical documents, I will use wording as it was. And in our region, this wording was Gypsy, Cigani. Roma settled in Slovenia in the 17th and 18th century, and it is interesting to say that among Roma community, there it is the custom, say that they should settle in the region where there are different religions. So Roma in Slovenia settled on the border region near in Prekmurje, which is near to Hungary, and there they had the historical contacts with the Jewish community, which settled also predominantly in that region in Slovenia. Then second group is located in southern part on near the border with Croatia, and there is also a small group of Sinti living on the northern part near Austria. So if we refer to statistical data, Roma community in Slovenia, only talking about Roma community in Slovenia today, only 3,246 persons declare them as Roma, but estimations are that the number is bigger, about 10,000. And what is the specific situation in Slovenia? Half of them are traditionally settled Roma, which I mentioned in Dolenska and in the Prekmurje region, but half of them, approximately about 5,000, came from other parts of ex-Yugoslavia, which was a common state for 70 years. And for research on Roma genocide, it is very important because the experience of these people, Roma people coming from other parts of ex-Yugoslavia, differs a little bit, and also their memory. If here, as I mentioned, that it is important to know also historical facts, I have to say that I had the opportunity to work in the archives in Novo Mesto and also in Maribor, and to see these original documents on which were aimed to stop nomadic way of life of Roma. It was actually the criteria to define this identity was not ethnic identity, but they were defined from the perception of minority history by their nomadic way of life. And here I will just quote one of these documents where they describe who are Roma. At that time, the terminology used was Cigani. So it was adopted 100 years ago, this decree. I will read it out. This decree considers gypsies as nomadic people with a traveling way of life who do not have a residence and travel alone with families or in groups to gather means of survival by carrying out traveling crafts and trading or by begging or in another irregular manner. So it was written 100 years ago. They were, because of this nomadic way of life and different lifestyles, they were their way of life was connected back to the pregnancy, plague, criminal, and stigmatism led to stigmatization and marginalization of this group. Perception of majority was that they have to stop to travel and the authorities have to force them to work. So in these documents, I quoted only one of these because we don't have enough time, but it was main message was we have to force them to work, they have to send children to school, and otherwise they were expelled from their territories. And this, because there were not contacts between majority population and Roma, this led to prejudices, stereotypes, and because there was, as I mentioned, there were no contacts, these prejudices prevailed and hatred and expulsion of Roma started. It went in the Second World War started, Slovenia was divided in three occupational regimes. Slovenia was occupied on one side Hungarians, Germans, and Italians. And all these regimes had a different, or they had a negative approach towards Roma, but also different measures. For example, most documented is the situation of Sinti, in the region occupied by Germans. Documents were very clear. You will be expelled, killed, or leave the territory. In the region which was occupied by Italy, Roma families were sent to forced labor camps in Gomars, Rava, and some of Roma from Slovenia were sent also to Jasenovac, it was a concentration camp in Croatia. Research on the Roma genocide, as in other countries, European countries, started only in the late 70s. And here I will quote one of our experts, Janik Schipper, who collected data also from the societies of partisan movement. And he, inter alia, he found that some Roma were included also in liberation, partisan liberation movement. Some of them were sent to concentration camps. I remember the story of one Roma from the Gorinska region who was deported to Dachau, and he came together with some other Slovenian prisoners to Slovenia by foot. Why it is important? It is important to talk about this, because in Slovenia there is not awareness about this persecution of Roma. And when I gave the lecture in Maribor some years ago about this, after the lecture, a lady came to me and then she said, it is important, it is something new for me, because my grandfather told me in the childhood that actually in Dachau his best friend was Roma. But without this spoken, you know, without opening the issue, you know, in Slovenia there is really still a very, very low presence of understanding of the situation of Roma during the World War. And within this research of Vanek Schipper, this research was made 30 years ago, he also published a document where about the persecution of Roma from Novo Mesto, where there are names listed of 77 Roma who were sent to Auschwitz, and no one of them returned. Among these 77 persons, 20 of them were children. And so I just wanted to say that this issue is new in Slovenia. It is new in academic circle. But it is also new situation within the Roma community who were only recently ready to talk about this. Before, you know, when we tried to find some testimonies, they said, please don't ask, it was terrible, you know. And then it happened that, for example, when these young Roma intellectuals, Roma activists, they started to ask their grandparents, and they were very, very hard, it was very hard to open discussion, but they started to speak, and it is very important to have these original testimonies. If we go to the research, I have to mention the research project, which started together with Synagoga, Tears of Stone, and we published within this project also two publications, and being one of these publications is we published a testimony of one Roma woman who, after 50 years, first spoke about her experience to her grandson and who published this in their book. So it is really the beginning also in Slovenia. It is important to raise awareness at the academic level, but also within Roma community. And here I have to say that our Roma Union in Slovenia, which is based in Murska Sobota, they also made a research. And here in this book, Korajnos, because in Roman language in Slovenia they use Korajnos, they published testimonies of the victims of Roma genocide from Prekmurje. And also on 2nd of August, already 3 years since, already 3 years now, they prepared a kind of seminar, discussion, and also visit a monument, which was built 3 years ago. So what I'm talking about is that there are fragmentary research on the position of Roma in Slovenia. But the awareness is still very low, and these monuments are important as for a local community, as for Slovenia as a country, but also for Roma themselves, to open their mind. Maybe I will have to stop, but I have a lot to tell more. You know, maybe that also in Slovenia, Roma were hesitant to speak about this issue because of the pain they still feel. But they express themselves through songs, paintings, in literature. And here also I have one book about this. And if there will be time for discussion, I would like to hear your opinion and to share with you also some other findings of the research, but also to understand more the perception of Roma who were persecuted and who were not, ready to share their pain, they just feel it inside. And now, because now we have also a group of young Roma intellectuals, they are ready to open also their heart to other members of the community, but also to majority population. Thank you very much.